Good morning, student. I am Saraswati Narasimha, your biology teacher. I welcome you in this online class, and this class is for class 10s. In your previous classes, we have started the life process and completed the first process, that is nutrition process. And in this class, we have discussed reaction three process, that is respiration, transformation, or excretion process. Then first we have discussed about the respiration process. The food taken during the process of nutrition is used to cells to provide energy for various activities or life process, and that energy comes from the breakdown of food and releasing energy, and that energy are utilized to our body for various life activities. Then the energy releasing process from food are called respiration process. Energy releasing process from food.
Muscle cells, and here
लैक ऑफ ऑक्सीजन गिव लैक्टिक एसिड हम ग्लूकोज लैक्टिक एसिड प्लस एनर्जी इट इज हैपेंड इन मसल्स सेल्स ड्यू टू लैक्टिक एसिड्स मसल्स क्रैम्स आर अवर देन एनएरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन एंड एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इट मींस एब्सेंस ऑफ O2 एब्सेंस ऑफ O2 इट गिव्स इट ब्रेक डाउन ग्लूकोज टू पाइरूवेट प्लस एनर्जी देन पाइरूवेट आर ब्रेक डाउन इन कॉल्ड इथेनॉल प्लस इथेनॉल कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड एंड एनर्जी सो दिस इज द रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस एंड आवर रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस वेयर ग्लूकोज इज ब्रेक डाउन एंड गिव पाइरूवेट प्लस एनर्जी इन साइटोप्लाज्म ऑफ द सेल देन दिस इज द थ्री टाइप्स हियर ऑक्सीजन इज प्रेजेंट लैक ऑफ ऑक्सीजन एंड एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इट्स ऑल हैपेंस इन साइटोप्लाज्म बट ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस द एनर्जी प्रोड्यूस इन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इज मच मोर देन एन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इट प्रोड्यूस 38 एटीपी मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ एनर्जी एंड हियर ओनली 2 एटीपी मॉलिक्यूल्स ऑफ एनर्जी आर प्रोड्यूस सो एनर्जी प्रोड्यूस इन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन इज मच ग्रेटर देन एन एरोबिक रेस्पिरेशन एंड इट इज हैपेंड इन माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया एंड द लैक ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इट इज ऑकर इन मसल सेल एंड इट इज ड्यूरिंग द फर्मेंटेशन ड्यूरिंग द सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन इज यूज टू फ्यूल फॉर ऑल अदर एक्टिविटीज ऑफ द सेल एनर्जी रिलीज ड्यूरिंग द सेलुलर रेस्पिरेशन इज सिंथेसिस इज यूज टू सिंथेसिस एटीपी एंड दैट इज यूज एज ए फ्यूल फॉर ऑल अदर एक्टिविटीज सो दिस इज द प्रोसेस ऑफ रेस्पिरेशन लेट वी सी द रेस्पिरेशन प्रोसेस ऑफ ह्यूमन बींग्स
blood vessels are present
supplied to the all parts of the body. Then it is the process of respiration process of the human beings. See again, as air enters to the body. Then this is all about the respiratory system in human beings. Let we discuss about the respiratory system or respiration process in plants. Plants have three basic components for their respiration, that is stomata. Stomata, plants respire through stomata. Then second is lenticel. Lenticel. Third one is the root surface. Root surface. Through stomata, plant absorbs gases. That means at the process of photosynthesis, they absorb carbon dioxide from the environment, and at the process of respiration. At the process of respiration, they absorb, stomata absorb oxygen from the environment. Then lenticel, it is present in stem of the tree. It is present in stem of the tree, and it is also help in the respiration in plants. Then root surface, through these also plant respire. Then in plant respiration process and photosynthesis process are reverse. Photosynthesis process are reverse. How the reverse? See, in respiration glucose breakdown C6H12O6 breakdown and give. In respiration process, glucose breakdown during at the presence of oxygen give carbon dioxide plus water. So this is respiration process and this is the photosynthesis process. So see, this is the reverse process, because in photosynthesis process, at the presence of sunlight, plants make their food and give oxygen and glucose. But in the respiration process, glucose breakdown at the presence of oxygen gives carbon dioxide and water. This is the respiration process of plants. Next we see the transmutation process of the next process is the transmutation process. Transmutation process. Transport means transportation of substance from different parts of the body. So first we see that transportation of substance in human beings, or transportation process in human beings. Blood is the connective tissue in humans. It transports necessary substance to cells and transport metabolic waste product away from the cells. So blood is called the connective tissue, and transportation of substance is occurred through the blood. So blood, the four main components of blood are help in transportation of substance, that is as is other waste product. Other waste product. Then second is RBC. It contains hemoglobin. Hemoglobin and hemoglobin. Hemoglobin and hemoglobin transfer oxygen to the all parts of the body. Then third is platelets. Platelets help in blood clotting. Then last main components is WBC. Full form of WBC means white blood cells and RBC means red blood cells. WBC, it kills the toxic materials and fight against the bacteria. So these four are the main components of blood. So first we see the transportation of necessary substance or oxygen through blood to the different parts of the body. First heart pump the blood through the blood vessels. So first we discuss about the heart. Heart is muscular organ made up of muscles, and it is divided into two sides. Then they are in lungs, the blood are purified, that means pulmonary artery drop brings oxygenated blood and move to the left atrium, and here the right ventricle are expanded, and the expanded of right left ventricle, the left atrium oxygenated blood are moved to left ventricle, and here the these side of left ventricle are compressed. Then the oxygenated blood are moved through the aorta to different parts of the body. So this is the transportation process in human beings, means transportation of oxygenated blood to the different parts of the body. Imagine this is human body. See this simple diagram and imagine this is a human body, and here so the vena cava blood are enters to the blood are comes from human body and enters to the heart. Then through the pulmonary arteries it moves to the lungs, and deoxygenated blood are moved to the lungs, and here deoxygenated blood means deoxygenated blood means peri carbon dioxide plus the carbon dioxide drop here and oxygenated blood are again moved to the pulmonary veins to heart, and from heart through the aorta move to the different part of the body. So see, all pulmonary artery carry oxygenated blood. All pulmonary artery carry oxygenated blood, except this. All pulmonary artery contain oxygenated blood, except this, and all pulmonary veins. All veins contain deoxygenated blood, except pulmonary veins, and all arteries contain deoxygenated blood, except pulmonary arteries. So this is the transportation process of human beings. Let's see the transportation process of plants. In plants, see, this is the simple diagram of the plants, and soil, water move from soil through the roots to the different parts of the or kitchen or leaf of the plants, and water move through the xylem vessels. Here two types of vessels are present, that is called xylem vessels and perm vessels, and both are called vascular bundle means vascular bundle means xylem and vessels, this and perm, xylem and perm. Xylem helps in transportation of water from soil to the different parts of the plants, and perm helps in the transportation of food material, that is prepared at the time of photosynthesis, to the different parts of the plant's body. So in plants, transportation process involved in vascular bundle, and xylem and perm are helped in the transportation of substance in the different types of the different part of the plants. So it is a transportation process of plants. So this process is also close that we discuss the last process in our life processes, that is excretory or excretion process. So let me discuss excretion process. It is a waste removal process. Many kind of waste in a process in which waste are removed from the body. So excretion is the process in which the metabolic waste of the body are removed outside, and digestive waste, second respiratory where speech creates from which hard is a nitrogenous waste. Nitrogenous waste. We already discussed the digestive waste, that is how it is removed from our body, and in this class today I discuss the respiratory waste, that means how CO2 removed from our body. Then next is nitrogenous waste. Nitrogenous waste means urea, uric acid and water. Urea, uric acid and water. So we next we see the nitrogenous waste, that means urea, uric acid and water. Water, how it is removed from our body. Human beings involve two kidneys, two ureters, urinary bladder, urethra. In kidney, urine filter from the blood, and in ureter, the filtered urine are supplied to the ureter to the urinary bladder, and in urinary bladder, urine are stored, and through the urethra it removed outside from the body. In lungs, blood are filtered. Blood are filtered from or separated from CO2. In lungs having filtration units, that is called alveoli. Just like that, in kidney also having filtration unit, that is called nephron, and that separate the urine from blood. And in kidney, nephrons are present, and many nephrons are present here. In kidney, cluster of involved capillary blood capillaries are present, and end of that capillary is coxa and is present, that is called Bowman's capsule, and that is helping filtration of urine from blood, and filtered urine are sent to the ureter, that is tube-like structure, and here are the reabsorption of substances like glucose, amino acid, water, etc. Then wastes are sent to the urinary bladder. When urine are entered through the urinary bladder, it expands its size, and urine is stored here for some time. Then through the urethra, urines are removed from the human's body. So this is the excretory system in human beings. This excretory system in plants. Excretion in plants. In plants, waste materials are removed as a form of leaf, gum, resin. Old leaf are collected as plant because they have waste materials.